All right, Montell, Toney, we went over the rules in the dressing room. I won a good, clean fight. I obey my commands at all times. Shake hands. Good luck to both of you.
James Toney versus Montell Griffin for the IBF Intercontinental Light Heavyweight Championship. Toney having that same stare that he had before in his eyes, but the question that many are going to ask is, how is that loss to Roy Jones Jr. going to affect him tonight? Losses have been known to change fighters totally inside the ring. Melvin Taylor, Julio Cesar Chavez. Now we're going to see whether or not we can add James
Toney. Let him out clean, let him out clean, let him out clean. Get him out of there, guys.
Men inside the ring, there really is no any difference in the bottom. Right now, Toney, without a doubt, is the bigger man.
I don't want you holding, guys. Come on, no holding.
He's a natural line heavyweight. Toney has had to build himself up. Toney's a fighter who tends to good exchange. Now, Toney tends to balloon after every fight. Sometimes getting over 200 pounds in weight. Trying to establish some respect from Toney with that left jab. Left hook quickly in there. It's that left jab that he's really gunning for tonight. Big left again, though.
Come on, get up, get up. Let's go.
Toney got some, apparently. James Toney is a very slow starter when he gets in the ring. In fact, he's only won one fight out of his last 13 before the sixth round. It's a fighter that does not like to get things early, get things done early, for that matter. Even though he's named his lights out, he tends to turn them off pretty late during the fight. As was the case last July here, Prince Charles Williams waited until the final round to knock his opponent out. But when he knocks you out,
just hold it up, guys. Keep him up, keep him up, keep him up, guys.
Right now, neither fighter really being stunned early on. Both fighters analyzing each other. And Griffin will pose some problems for Toney in this fight because he is a fighter with a different type of style. And he's quick. He's got a jab that is so far connected early on against Toney's.
Okay, let's not work out in there. Come on, work out.
Less than 10 seconds left in the round.
I like the right hand, but just a few more jabs to go and get off a little faster. Get off a little faster. Clench his mouth. Give him a little water. More jabs. When you come with that right hand, even if you miss it, come back with that left hook. I don't need
that. Keep giving him. Keep giving those things, and just keep walking on. Look this guy over there, okay? Okay? Keep putting those combinations in there. Two or three
fights. Eddie Futch, the trainer for Montell Griffin. Of course, Futch is also the trainer for Riddick Bowe. One person missing from Tony's corner, Jackie Callen. Usually she's always in his corner, but apparently for this fight, she's not. Many say that their relationship has gone sour and that the reconciliation is just mainly for show that once their contract expires in July, look for Toney to head elsewhere with his business. What's been effective for Montell Griffin so far has been the left jab, followed by a quick left hook.
Oh, what's that shoulder? What's that coming in with that shoulder? What's that shoulder?
He's that type of fighter. Very lethargic, just tends to analyze his opponent.
Work out it. Watch your heads inside. Watch your heads inside, guys.
For Toney, boxing is more of a chess match rather than another
sport. Work out, guys. Come on.
The right angles to take the opponent out. There's another stiff jab by Griffin. Griffin showing much more speed than Toney, and it shows that the added weight that Toney has had to gain might be affecting him.
Watch your heads inside. Watch your heads inside.
He usually does gain a lot of weight after the weigh-in. He came in at 184 pounds against Roy Jones Jr. You got to wonder what he came in at tonight. But still, James Toney does not have the speed he once had, and Carl Griffin is capitalizing on that at this moment.
Come on. Break out to me. Sit back.
Joe Cortez, the third man in the ring tonight, separating the two fighters. Griffin missing with the hook, just grazing the top of Toney's head. Less than a minute left here in round two. Let's get to a smart 12-round fight. Toney not really throwing the jab like his corner told him at the end of the first round. Said you need to establish yourself more with the jab, and he hasn't done that. See, this is where Griffin can capitalize by finishing strong. Toney hasn't shown much action, and if he tends to put a couple of flurries together at the end, that helps him out. Oh, two punches there thrown by Griffin, one after the bell, but the first one did stun Toney.
Go stand in front of him.
And look, remember, you can use that jab a little more often. See, because he's not expecting that jab to be that faint. Faint and sick, that left hand.
Okay.
And remember that hook.
Okay.
Double hook once in a while. And when you're pulling out, don't pull out standing up straight.
Okay, pull out.
Yeah. Okay. All right. That's good.
You see, Matai?
Take your time.
Catch him now.
All right.
Him up,
take your time. When you catch him, back with the hook, not one punch.
Run your time, dog. It's all your words.
You can't do that, Bob. Okay. It's your word, baby.
During the course of the intermission there, you did hear Toney saying, I'll catch him. I'm taking my time. I'll catch him now. Toney, though, was also huffing and puffing a lot in the third round of this fight. So we got to question his shape coming into this round. Both fighters here, and Griffin stuns Toney with the left. Sends him against the ropes. Toney now looking to fight off the ropes. Advantage with that left jab, even though he doesn't have the reach advantage.
Get him out of there.
You wonder what type of fighter Toney would be if he throws jab. He's not known for it. There he gets two quick shots.
Work out of there. Come on, get him out.
Griffin can steal some of the early rounds, as has been the case thus far, it appears. and he's got a good chance going to the later rounds. She is, he's got to survive past Toney. Right now, Tony's shape, big left there by Griffin, but Toney just tends to just pause and look up. But if Toney's shape plays a factor in this run, which it looks as if it might, by the Huffington Puff of us on the last
mission,
Griffin perhaps might be able to pull off a virtual huge upset here, because Toney is a 5-1 favorite.
Get him out of there.
Toney tends to have a lot of problems with fighters who are a lot quicker than him. So far, Griffin has shown that. We have a cheap shot there behind, and Toney just winks it off. Looks at George Foreman and winks it. Says it was nothing. But talking about quick fighters, that's what happened with Roy Jones. Jones was just too much speed, and his timing was there. Killed Toney. That awkward style of a fighter, smaller guy who tends to move a lot, gives Toney a lot of problems. And that's what Griffin is doing exactly the same. Oh, and a big right there, and Griffin is gone. Griffin is just gone. Griffin does not know what hit him. He is just dazed. And Toney now looking to finish it. Less than 10 seconds, Griffin just hoping to survive this run. They might have to finish this one in the corners. Toney connects with the right, and Griffin was dancing all over the place. Let's now go to the corners.
Give me his sponge. Montell, look at me, son. You all right?
Yeah.
You know where you are?
Yeah, I'm the baby.
Okay.
MG.
Look at me one more time.
Las Vegas, MG.
Feel good enough, guard?
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
Dr. Flipomansky checking with Griffin.
Okay.
The Nevada Athletic Commission. Here's a look again at the punch
doing,
that pretty much rocked right there. A big right connects on Griffin. And just watch him dance here, folks. That is called the ring waltz. And it's not pretty once it is implanted, as was the case right there. Toney, not really much on that punch. It was just a quick right. But there was a lot of power behind that punch. Boom. Round four. Toney now looking to finish Griffin off. Toney did say prior to that round, I'll catch him. I'll catch him now. And he more than caught him. Griffin's old fight plan has got to be shot now. He knows he's in trouble. What he's trying to do is get back some of his concentration from earlier.
Punch again.
And Toney just walking in slowly, hunting in on his prey. Waiting for the right time to attack.
Toney might want to go after
him a bit stronger and try to take him out this round. Has not been the case, though, early on. But there is still 2 minutes left in the round. And that in boxing can seem like an eternity.
Punch again, let's go.
You can tell that Griffin is a different fighter. He's not as active as he once was before. And it looks as if his biggest concern now is not being hit rather than doing the hitting as he was earlier. Should Toney finish him off before round six? The first knockout Toney has had since Tim Little's last March out in Los Angeles, which finished in the fourth round. A great fight that was. Toney was told he had to finish it in one round, and he did. Big miss there by James.
Get him out of there. Come on, work out. Let's go.
tell, though, if he's a different fighter.
Oh, what kind of
thing?
It's
a loss to Jones. Exchanging blows. Toney appearing to get the better end of that one. Less than 10 seconds here in round four. And Montell Griffin survives.
Time.
A drastic punch at the end of round three. Let's go to the corners. Listen in.
Bing, 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 and come out of it with something. But pick up the pace a little bit. You hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Keep setting him up, baby. Keep setting
pick up the pace a little bit.
Your night, James.
This is your thing.
Pick up the pace. Your night, James.
Take it, take it to another level now. I want to see something.
Good shit. It's your world,
dog.
It's your world.
All right.
All right. Take this boy to school. Take this boy to school.
Let's put a little more pressure on him now.
Take him to school, dog. All right, seconds out.
Give me another round. Just like that, okay? Oh, big cool stay near the center of the ring, okay? All right, David, get one point.
James' corner, Tony's corner, telling Toney to take him to school. It's time to take him to school. Griffin was a good student early on.
Let him out clean.
Griffin seems to regain some of his early on composure, starting to establish himself more with the jab early here in round number five.
Come on, work out there, work out. Oh, keep him up, guys, both of you guys.
Tony just attacking the body, trying to wear him down slowly but surely.
Punch it out.
You wonder if those punches have any effect. Griffin with a quick 1-2 left to right. A lot of credit, though, goes to Tony's chin.
Come on, give him up, Tony.
Was floored in the Jones fight. Now Griffin started to put on a little bit of attack here in the middle of round five. He's got Tony's against the wall, but Tony just seems to be just looking and waiting.
Come on, work out of there, guys. Come on, guys, work out of there, come on.
Griffin follows him up with the left. Another left. It's mainly been his main weapon now, just that left. And Toney now starting to take advantage. Fighting off the ropes and doing a solid job at it.
Get your hands out. Come on, let's go, work out of there. Come on,
Griffin appeared to hit Toney once. Toney retaliates with three quick punches.
Oh, look at
it. Both fighters down the corner, where they have been for the past minute or so. And Griffin trying to find an angle in which he can hurt James Toney. Trying to find a way to dent his armor.
We're gonna watch your hands inside.
But so far, Toney not showing any holes.
We're gonna.
He's been a bit of a trouble here in the corner, but he's found himself tremendous back up, getting the better end of it. Finishing the round strong, connecting him with the left and the right while Griffin's barely getting it. Now Griffin comes back, and Toney turns him. Quick left, and that kind of hurt Toney. Toney trying to turn him late, but the bell rang. And Griffin landing a couple punches there that seemed to daze Toney for a quick second. But like we mentioned earlier, Toney is a very difficult fighter to knock out. There is a look at Oscar De La Hoya. He will be taking on John Molina following this bout. Oscar, the pride of East LA, the 1992 Olympic gold medalist from Barcelona, And he says he is ready. He said he has never felt stronger for a fight than this one. That's coming up next. Talking about Toney, he's only been forward a couple of times.
Watch pulling back. When you pull back after a jab, that's when he tries to pull that long right hand. Gotta get underneath. All right.
Okay. Give me another round.
Light him up and turn him around.
Toney appeared to be saying to Miller's manager in the corner, his trainer, I'm having fun. Montell Griffin is not. This has been Tony's game plan. He has executed it well. Usually it's the same as Toney has for all fights. Griffin that thus far. He's had a valiant effort.
Get him out of there.
Not the same box that he was prior to that big punch at the end of it.
Work out of there.
Both fighters just going at it in slow motion. Just about. Joe Cortez probably having a tough time in the office with this one. Crowd starting to boo. Actually, he's slowed down tremendously compared to what it was before. Toney's eventual goal is to get up to a heavyweight status of a fighter. First, he wants to win a couple of championships on the light heavyweight division. The crowd booing the action we have seen thus far here in round six. Less than 30 seconds coming up right now left in this round. Griffin hasn't had much contact with the right tonight, and his left has slowed down. While Toney now appeared to be getting the advantage on the punches landed. The fighters coasting. Late shot there on Montell Griffin. That appears to have irritated Toney a bit. He's just laughing. Joe Cortez warning.
They're not jabbing enough. Look here. The guy's sitting right there. Short guy. Man, short.
Work on the outside a little bit, Montell. See, the rounds are close. If you work on the outside a little bit, keep that chin down, use that jab, and use that fake that you were using earlier in the fight. And on the inside, you use that double hook. Double and triple
stay on
hook.
Outside.
Pardon?
Stay on the outside.
I want you to stay on the outside. I want you in and out.
Oh, okay.
In and out. When you get inside, I want you to work inside.
Okay. Let's now take a look at the end of the last round, and you'll see the late hit here, right there. Toney, a bit irritated afterwards.
All right, seconds
There's
out.
There's a warning by Joe Cortez. I think Toney, in his mind, knows that he can take Griffin out whenever he wants to. Just wants to know to win. of Toney has been gaining more strength as a fighter. He's starting to do a lot more. Griffin has never lost a fight. Right now, it appears that maybe on his way. Tony gets Toney in the corner, and he comes to the left, but it doesn't phase him. Just watch right on him. Take some more heat. Misses with a big left, Griffin does. Crowd booing, because they have not seen a knockdown yet. There was a questionable knockdown scoring in the third round. You're going to wonder how they're going to score that one, if they're going to score the 10-8 round, which Toney connected with a quick, sharp right. With a lot of power behind it, and it dazed Griffin. To the point that Flipper Man's gonna get in the corner afterwards and ask Griffin, where are you, son? Not a bad exchange of ropes. Body, really, no big action.
Work out.
Not much work done so far between the two fighters. In fact, most of the work tonight will be done by Art Murray, Bill Graham, and Dwayne Ford, the three judges. Currently judging this fight. Oh, and Griffin knocks Toney backward, but Toney just shakes it off. The crowd comes wild. You're going to wonder how they're going to score that. Griffin now starting to put on his attack. And Toney's a bit dazed, it looks, but he's coming back. And new life shown by Montell Griffin here late in the fight.
Don't let this man back in this fight.
Here's a look again from the action. What it was it appears it was just a punch that grazed the top of his head. So he just kind of backed away to get away from the action. Kind of like tripped it, looks like. Comes the left. Then followed up with a quick left, and Toney kind of like lost his balance. But there was some force in those punches. He shook it off. But I yet to have seen a boxer show anyone that he is hurt. Intentional.
All right, seconds out.
Do something now. Turn the fight around.
Okay. Okay. Feel it.
Let's go, James. Get busy, man. Let's go.
This appears to be a close fight. Some people here see this one around either way. Griffin. Griffin here finding new life after the end of the last round. Some people here near ringside actually leading this fight. I think if it was in James Toney's best interest tonight, he would have taken this guy out early to prove everyone that he is back from that Roy Jones Jr. fight. The only thing that he's proving now is that it's pretty much the James Toney of old. Which at times can be scary, which at times can also be very boring. Griffin now coming in on attack, but really missing with most of his punches. knocks him off balance. Griffin comes right back to the body. And Toney starting to put the combinations together. Some swelling now under Montell Griffin's right eye. Apparently goes less by Toney, having an effect on Griffin's face.
All right, break out clean. Break out.
Less than 10 seconds left here in the round. Round number 8 of a scheduled 12 rounder. This is for the IBF Intercontinental Light Heavyweight Championship.
Keep close. With 1 point behind. Let's take over the fight, son.
Take over, baby. You can hurt him when you
come on. Look here. When you just step to the left and shoot the left hook. Put the left hook. I want to see it. Well, tell me, okay, Pop. Jab, step to the left, pop that hook. All right. Put some pressure on this man. I ain't seen a right hand down the pike since that one you hit him and hurt him with. Let me see something.
Meet that jab. On the inside, you've got to work. And you can't come out standing up straight. You've got to come down low.
Get the towel.
And to the right.
Mark.
Up to your right.
Out.
All right.
5 seconds out.
Two different fighters in the corner. Montell Griffin appeared to be right at the top. Meanwhile, James Toney could barely understand a word what the guy was saying. He is tired. He was huffing and puffing. And he was told by his corner that he is now down to one round. He needs to pick up the pace. I did mention earlier, James Toney had a lot of problems making the weight. He was sweating off pounds yesterday afternoon. So his physique is not at the point that I'm sure he wanted to be at. It's up to James Toney. Would love coming into this pond. This fight at weight about a week ago. Montell Griffin now starting to get his second win in this fight, working that jab.
Get him out of there. Get those arms out. You can work out of there. Come on.
Had an effect on Toney tonight. Might not see it in his face, but it has slowed him down a bit. And he is scoring points. That's the key, because Griffin knows that to beat Toney, as Griffin puts together a good combo there, but Toney just bobs and weaves his way out of it. To beat Toney, he's got to beat him by decision. I think many here along ringside would like to see what kind of right Griffin is.
Get him out.
The midway point of round number 9. Griffin getting the better of it so far.
Get him out.
Toney not showing much action after his round told him that he was down. First quarter told him that he was down by a round. You don't see a different fighter.
Get him out.
This is his game plan. Jab, and hook. Big. Very close to him.
Get him out of there. Come on, guys.
Give Griffin a lot of credit thus far. He's only 14-0. He was an amateur 2 years ago. Actually, 3 years ago. He's not fighting like this now. As he's getting the better of Toney there in the corner. And Toney now coming on. There's some blood there on that shoulder, Toney, it appears.
Get the hand over there.
Trying to land the big right. It is his main weapon.
Let it go.
That's the end.
better.
That's better. But you can even give me more than that. Huh? You can give me better than that, can't you? But give it to me.
No, you in great shape. This motherfucker can't do that with you.
I got the alley.
Treat yourself, baby. Don't treat yourself. You hear me?
We're coming down the wire. This is our rounds.
Come on.
We need all of these. We need every round to come in.
I heard him again. You at home now. You heard him again, right? Mm-hmm. All right. So go on and take him on top of this bitch.
Hey, let's
keep that pressure off.
The last time anything huffed and puffed like James Toney, the three pigs were left home.
Keep that pressure on.
This guy is tired.
Cut out the pretty badly. Get out. Pressure on.
Start of round 10. Griffin starts to hold on. He feels that he's in control of this fight. Toney needs these last three rounds.
Get him out there. Come on. Get him out.
The ladder's playing possum. Oh, missing wildly there with the left. Seeing this round, he had a flashback to the Jones fight. The guy was quicker, beating out the slower Toney.
Get him out.
Side is behind. I think Toney thinks he's winning. And he might be. There's a big right there by Toney, but it doesn't faze Griffin at all. Griffin just continues pouring on the attack with left jab.
Come on, work out it. Your hands are free.
After that flash punch that really hurt Griffin in the third round, tend to give Toney credit, but the last couple of rounds, Griffin pouring the action inside, as if, hey, I don't respect you anymore, guy. Your punches don't hurt me. I think Toney realizes that.
Tired, you gotta listen, okay? Listen, okay?
There's a look at the crowd here at the MGM Grand Garden. Right now, they are possibly watching a huge upset in the making. Montell Griffin had some problems there. Middle rounds, about three on. But he's poured it on late. And he's fighting the right type of fighter to pull off an upset. James Toney has not improved his image at all with this fight tonight. He's looking to say, I'm back, I'm the old James Toney. Well, thus far, he looks like the same guy that got manhandled by Roy Jones 3 months ago. Crowd here not impressed thus far with Toney's performance. And he's really a stubborn fighter, because if you looked at the last couple of rounds and you listened closely to what his corner was saying, he wasn't really following through. But Toney has been known that when it comes time to pour it on, he'll pour it on until he get that knockout. Right now he's got two rounds to get that.
I got that water quick.
12-round fight. IBF Intercontinental Light Heavyweight Championship is on the line.
Break out, please.
I think Griffin, if he was smart, he'd just try to use that left and move. Still do the same style. Don't get close to Toney. Still
dangerous. Your hands are free, guys. Your hands are free.
Tony's corner barking from James Toney. So far, Tony's bark has been a lot louder than his bite today.
Oh, get him out, get him out. Break out, clean.
Sorry, bro.
Okay, let's go. Break out, clean. Step back.
Traits a boxer can have is speed. If he has it, he'll win a lot of fights. If he doesn't, he'll lose. But right now, Griffin has the more speed.
Break out, I'll be hitting it. Let's go. You have it free, guys.
Toney's left eye now. Starting to swell up and it's starting to close. Those jabs have been having an effect on him already. That was part of his game plan. Eddie Flux told him to keep that jab in there. It's worked. He scores points. So far, it's worked.
Perfect. Break out.
Come to the final parts of round number 11.
I've got to have 3 minutes. Give me 3 minutes.
Lean up, James. Lean up.
3 minutes to win this fight. But we need it. Don't blow your nose. We got to have this last round. I need this last round. You hear me?
You want this fight, man? Listen, you want this fight, you can take it, okay? Yeah. But you got
to
be smart. Don't give him one. Box the guy, keep the left hand, keep walking around this way, okay?
Coming up. Touch him up.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Don't let him get nothing. He'll come out with a spurt, but I want you to be smart.
Yeah. In the night.
Get it home.
All right.
Get home, y'all. Let him happen, baby.
Fight.
Get him home, let him have it.
All right, yeah, no problem.
No prisoners, James.
Let's get this motherfucker.
All right.
Counterpunch.
Get out of here. I wonder what is going to that man's IBF Intercontinental Light Heavyweight Championship. 12 rounds and we're in the last one. Griffin in the red sparkling trunks.
Right,
Toney in the black trunks.
Bring him up, man. Give me clean out, guys.
Come on.
Let's go.
After being dazed early, Toney didn't try to take him out. He just played with him.
Come on, guys, give me a clean round. Break him up, break him up, guys. Come on, give me a clean round. Let's go.
Griffin looks like he's gonna get the last laugh in this one, possibly. A lot of credit, though, goes to good exchange right now. Left-right. A lot of credit, though, in this fight goes to Eddie Futch. Did a good job keeping the fighter in there. And now Griffin starting to put on the attack on James Toney. And Toney has got a minute and 15 seconds left in this round to do something. Montell Griffin is an underdog in this one. James Toney, a 5-1 favorite.
All right, come on, go. Bring out, Green. Bring out.
And it looks as if the favorite is about to get upset. Griffin now just adding insult to injury in the final seconds.
All right, get him out of there. Come on, punch it out. Come on, punch it out. Let's go, punch it out of there.
Seconds they can hug each other.
Goodbye, Jack.
Now the crowd here waiting to see what the decision for this fight will be. I personally think Griffin came back and took it away from him. And you wonder exactly what James Toney accomplished.
They ran all the way down there.
By this performance. We're possibly looking now at only the second man who's ever beaten James Toney.
We have to know because the interview is
a lot of credit, like the luncheon dinner. The gentleman right to his left there with the glasses. Papa Smurf, Eddie Futch. And there's James Toney in town. I think he knows this one's going to be a close one, if not a loss. Let's now go to the final decision with Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the MGM Grand, we go to the scorecards. Dwayne Ford scores the bell. 114 to 114, he has it even. Bill Graham scores the bell. 115 to 113. And Art Lurie scores at 116 to 112 for the winner by majority decision, Montell Ice Griffin.
Montell Griffin pulls off a huge upset tonight, a majority decision over James Lights Out Toney.